You've arrived. Just in time to meet the most mysterious man I know, Mr. Morton Vint.
Good morning, ladies.
Valentina, you look lovely, and Emily, you look like a flower in bloom.
May I tell it to Mother?
Well, don't mind Mr. Vint. He's well practiced in keeping secrets.
Emily is to be married.
How can this be? The last time I saw you, you were with the nuns.
I often wonder if the nuns shouldn't have kept her a few years more.
And who might this man be that has broken you from the shackles of the convent?
It's Lord Fullerton. Mother chose him for me.
It's just like your mother to have such ideas.
Elizabeth.
Adriana. You look stunning.
Thank you.
You two must have many more secrets to exchange, and Morton has some things he'd like to share with me, and I can see he's getting quite impatient to do so. He's lodging with the Mrs. Bordereau.
I haven't heard that name for years. How is the niece? How do you like her?
Morton, do tell. What news, if any, of your dear Miss Tina? His interest in some papers has become quite a fixed idea.
What papers of value could they possibly have?
That is what I'm trying to find out.
I mean, these two are from another age.
Yes, their manner has very little to do with ours. So, what more have you learned from her?
I've learned that her mind is essentially vague about dates and the order in which events occurred. Her story doesn't quite hang together. I've even asked myself if she's trying to lay a trap for me.
To make you show your hand, you mean?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, perhaps she doesn't even know of the existence of these papers.
I wrote to her.
You never told me that.
6 months before I arrived.
Did she answer?
Yes. To the second letter. She answered in 6 lines.
And what did she say?
Miss Bordereau requested that she had none of Mr. Aspern's papers. And even if she did, she would not think of showing them to anybody, on any account whatsoever.
Maybe after all this, they don't have any of his things. If they so flatly deny it, how can you be sure?
I am sure.
On what evidence?
Her calling him Mr. Aspern.
I don't see what that proves.
It proves familiarity, and familiarity implies possession of mementos. You don't say Mr. Byron or Mr. Shakespeare, do you?
Would I anymore if I had a box full of his love letters?
Yes, if you had been his lover and someone wanted them.
Well, it looks like that's the last of it.
Yeah.
Before I go, a little gift from my new star.
Oh, Penelope. Oh, wow. They're gorgeous. Thank you.
Luca and I are so excited to add you to our collection. I've got to run, but don't forget about our holiday party tomorrow night. I cannot wait to show you off.
Hey, I'll be there. Thank
Wonderful.
You.
Bye, ladies.
Bye. Let me know when you'd like me to come by to help install my art.
Of course, I will definitely keep you posted.
Great.
Maggie Amato, this is Akila Jeffries.
Akila, oh, I'm such a huge fan. I loved your lighting installation in Battery Park during Occupy.
Well, thank you, my dear. Are you coming to St. Bart's in February?
What?
She doesn't know it yet, but she is.
It's a fabulous artist retreat. We get a house and a yacht, and we just unplug.
I'm always my freest in St. Bart's.
Tell her how much fun it is, Akila.
A toast to St. Bart's?
St. Bart's.
You know, I can't make it. I'm sorry. I'm really thankful for everything, but I just don't feel that I'm the right fit for your collection.
Excuse me?
I didn't make all of this work for it to be buried in the artistic, sunken place. Merry Christmas. Good night.
Kinsley loves the idea.
Of course he loves the idea. Kingsley can't get enough of being in the spotlight.
Well, there's a little hitch.
Oh, we can include Audrey.
No, leave me out of this, please.
But isn't that where you two first met?
Oh, we could leave you out of it. As long as you ask Sarah Grace not to bring any protest signs this time.
My daughter has a voice to raise, too.
Not as a presidential candidate, she doesn't. She gets more press than he does.
Maybe because she stands for more? Education, freedom of speech, environmental protection laws?
Very easy to do when you don't need votes.
Honey, we don't want to push the voters away, do we?
Look, I get it. I just don't know how they're supposed to vote when they don't know who they're voting for. Okay. Okay, playing nice.
Honey, you remember Pamela's son, Eric? You went to camp together? Just moved back to the neighborhood.
What up, Ariel?
All right. Beep.
You've been in that hot tub all day.
You're gonna get a yeast infection.
I'm a mermaid, Mom!
Hello.
Hello, ma'am.
May I offer you some punch?
No, thanks.
Wait right here. I'll just go get my change, please.
There's no need. I'll just... I have to go back now to the office.
Please. Wait.
How can I help you?
Miss Reagan, could we speak to you in private?
What is this about?
We have evidence that affects the Chuck McMurdo case.
I'm Alan Murtaugh. This is my wife, Cynthia. We drove down from Westchester for the hearing.
Charles is innocent. He couldn't have done what you're accusing him of. He was with us the night of the shooting.
Why didn't you come forward earlier?
He doesn't want anyone to know about us.
I'm sorry, who are you?
We're his parents.
Nothing our son says about himself is true. He's as white as we are.
I don't understand.
He made up this myth about himself. He grew up in the suburbs, not in the ghetto.
And began lying about where he was from.
We thought it was just rebellion. When he was 12, he told us he'd always felt more black than white.
Trans, whatever.
Well, it doesn't seem so extreme these days.
Now he's got the record company encouraging him to put these lies to music.
They've kept him away from us. They're paying for his lawyer.
Alan, Cynthia, your son is accused of murder. He bragged about it in a song.
He's just trying to sell records, or however you make money now.
He was with us celebrating my birthday the night of this murder.
Then why wouldn't he offer you as an alibi?
Because he's ashamed. He told me he would find someone with more street cred to cover for him.
But now that it's getting all this publicity, we knew we had to get involved before he hurts his own case.
Can you prove that he was with you that night?
He made us delete all the photographs.
So it's just your word?
Oh, thank you for coming so quickly.
What happened?
After Thomas was arrested, his friends gave Charles a beating.
He's got four broken ribs, a broken collarbone, and a fractured eye.
He asked to see you right away.
I told you this would happen if I turned red.
You turned down protection, Chuck.
I didn't want anyone thinking I was soft.
If they beat him this badly after a hearing, what will they do if he testifies against his friend at a trial?
We'll make arrangements when the time comes.
You're still gonna make me do this?
It's a murder case, Chuck. Someone needs to stand up. Maybe it's your chance to show you are as hardcore as you claim to be.
Then where do I go?
You made a lot of money off that song. You can afford a nice long family vacation.
Write down your username and password for Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat.
What? You have no right to ask.
Leo, write them down.
Mom, we were just playing a game.
What kind of game, Leo?
It's this game where you suck a card against your lips, and then you try...
Blow it on someone else?
Yeah. Sometimes the card falls.
Okay, who are you playing lipstick party with?
I'm sorry, isn't that Leo's business?
Not anymore. Now, if you want, we can take your son in and have CSU do a body exam.
Lori, I need more cash. Hey, where's my free egg roll?
No egg roll.
It says over $25. You're supposed to get a free egg roll.
No egg roll.
I told them not to put it in. Fried dumplings and orange chicken. You don't need any more grease. Here you go. Keep the change.
But I like the egg roll.
Stop being a baby. Michael, I was just coming to see you.
I'm heading out.
No, just go in for a minute, please. I'm just so upset. I don't know who to go to.
For what?
To find out what's happened to Dave. Look, you were his best friend. Cops are useless, you know that. But can we please just go inside for a minute?
I can't do this.
Michael, I've known you a long time. Come on, please. Please, let's just go in for 1 minute.
Chillin'.
Michael, I want you to listen to this.
What the fuck are you playing?
You know goddamn well what I'm playing.
Yo, man, get the fuck off him. Listen to your own shit.
You know what this is, Michael. You listen to this. Listen to this. You tell me who murdered my son.
I don't know who fucking killed Dave. Your son was a fucking loser just like you.
You listen to this.
You're a fucking loser.
You listen to this. You tell me who murdered my son.
Fuck.
You little shit!
What are you doing here? Obviously, you want to see your son quicker than you think.
Am I making you nervous?
You're not making me nervous. You're giving me a pain. I want you to get the hell out of here. You don't belong here.
I'm just drinking my coffee.
You better behave yourself, because I don't discriminate. Okay? Take your cell phone and get the hell out of here if you know what's good for you.
Bridget, Roxanne, these are my friends from the city.
Hi.
We didn't think you'd make it.
Oh, we got lost. We took the wrong bridge.
Remember that feeling like if you left Manhattan even for a second, you'd fall off the edge of the earth?
No.
God, don't remind me.
Hi.
Oh, my God, it's the Bellini Baby Basket. Oh, look, everybody, it's the Bellini Baby Basket.
Yeah, Sheila, I've got the backpack. I'm doing my Sherpa routine.
Hey, you can't cut the line. Wait your turn.
Look, I gotta get out of here. I just waited 20 minutes for some moron to blow up balloons.
Well, you can't cut the line.
I've gotta go pick up my twins from preschool in 10 minutes. They fine you if you're late. Crazy, crazy, now showing everywhere. Population.
Move up, the line moved.
Yeah? Done. Where are you?
Getting goodie bag stuff. So much for sticking to your principles.
So much for sticking to your principles.
Move it, move up.
Did you know that 90% of cell phone users believe they're courteous, while 85% of those same users complain about being annoyed by others' conversations? Now, those numbers really don't add up, do they? You know what? You urban moms are like a case study in liberal hypocrisy.
Come on, you're up, you're up! Hello?
Hey, it's me.
Is everything okay?
Booker knows about us.
What?
And he got off their train to Croton Harmon trying to find you.
Find me?
Well, they might only know you live in Montrose.
How does he even have my address?
I don't know what he knows.
So, what's he gonna do, just show up at my door?
I don't know, baby.
What should I do? Do you want me to go out and look for him? Do you want me to wait for him here? It's been really hard since Randy and I separated. I'm president of the PTA, and that's a lot of responsibility on me. The kids are always hanging on to me. I have no help.
Lisa, if you had to make a choice between your family and drinking, what would you choose?
I don't know.
You would choose alcohol over your kids. I can't even comprehend that.
Lisa has no free will in this, Marlene. She's an alcoholic.
Everything we do in this life is a choice.
You think you're so much better than me? What the hell are you doing here, then?
Oh, it's got nothing to do with being like you.
Bitch. Okay, no name calling.
Your children didn't ask to be born. You are responsible to your kids.
Oh, but you're happy.
All right. Can we get 2 shots of Patron, please?
So, what's your name?
Big Tommy. Big Tommy. What's yours?
Mary.
Mary. I love that name. Look what we have here, Mary. Thank you very much, sweetheart. That's for you. Bottoms up, Mary.
Here's to your Big Tommy.
Mm-hmm.